everyone, and welcome back to our channel. My name is Kora.
And I'm Simeon.
We are the SNK of SK Dancesport. In today's tutorial, we are going to be teaching you guys how to do a hover corte with Develope. Kicks that we can do. We can do develope's, which is when you bend the knee first and kick out the leg second, or you can do envelope's, which is when you kick out first and bend the knee in. Yeah? In hover cortes, you always do them with develope's. I don't think I've ever seen one with an envelope. So we're not going to worry about that one, but doing a hover corte with develope is actually really, really beautiful. Yeah? Definitely one of my favorite moves, especially because being a 10 dancer, I can kick up high. So I always wanted to take advantage of kicking as high as I could. So we're gonna give you guys some tips and tricks for how to do that, especially for you girls, this is a tough step. Guys, also remember to find us on our social media channels. Our social media channels are Instagram, at SKDanceSport. We also have, it's down there. And you can also find us on Facebook. Yeah, other than that, let's get moving.
Guys, let's go over the man's part. Now, if there are some details that we're gonna skip in this video, it's because we probably have other videos like heel turns, things like that. So the first step we start with is a double reverse spin over spin. And basically what that means is as a pivot at the end of it. Normal double reverse spin, you lower at on the second step, so you go forward, side, and you lower on that right foot. In this case, we're gonna stay high, and actually I would say even higher to lower on the next step. So I add another pivot on it. On my left foot, and I corkscrew down on that left foot, so on the third step instead of normally on the second step. So it will go something like this. I'm gonna go one, two, three onto my left foot, okay? Now from here, and I can turn it more or less, but in my case, I was going diagonal out of this. Hover, I like to do hover. Like for example, if there's the corner of the room, I like to go to the corner of the room, or if I'd be going down the line of dance, I go toward the, basically diagonal wall. Is where I'm facing. So wherever I finish my double reverse spin, I'm gonna head a little more diagonal out of there, okay? So let's say I finish on my left foot. From here, I'm gonna do the hover. The first time I'm gonna do hover, there's just a slight difference for me. I'm gonna go one, two, so back and side. This is oftentimes considered a promenade, kind of a promenade step. Even though I'm not in full promenade in my body, I'm stepping kind of a promenade, so opening my foot a lot more out than I normally would. Now, we did do the develope with the hover, right? So hover with the develope. And that one, I just slightly changed my footwork. And I wouldn't advertise it too much to everybody, but this is how I do it. And I always tell you guys exactly what I do, okay? But when I do a hover, I go ball flat, and then I rise up onto my toe, and then I come out of that toe, so I don't put this heel down. I go really high. When I do the hover with develope, I want the extra stability so that I can lead the drop, and then I go up on my toes. So the very first time I hit kind of like that hover position before the drop for the develope, I don't want to go up on my toe, okay? So I wouldn't do one, two, toe, drop, toe. I would keep my foot flat, but stretch a lot with my body. So I'm gonna go still back on one, two, still the same on a ball flat, but instead of rising on my toe, I'll rise after the develope. But the first rise is on a flat foot with big stretch in the body. Kora finishes. Yeah, she's gonna go up on her toe. Okay, but I'm gonna keep it flat. From here on count four. So that's gonna be one, two, three. You can go extra four, five, six. I think I did one, two, three, and then I lower on four. And the reason I keep my heel down is that now when I lower, I'm, first of all, much more stable to start, stable position to start with, but also I'm a little closer to the base, yeah? So I go three, and then I lower four, and that's when she kicks up. So four, then I push up five. You you see that? So I'm going up on my toe up on five, on the kind of the second part of the hover after the developing. Because I hit that hover position twice. Once here, then we lower, she kicks. I hit it a second time before I exit. That second time, I'm like a normal traditional hover up on my toe. The first time, I'm on a flat foot. Outside change is really slow. It's like rock solid, okay? So from here, I'm gonna go outside partner, leader outside partner. I'm gonna go one, two, and lower on three in promenade position. In our case, you could go close. And we're gonna do an open natural. One, two, three, also known as a passing natural.
All right, ladies, so now let's go over your part. Remember that we are doing a double reverse with an overspin, and then we're gonna do our hover corte, outside change, and passing natural. Now, double reverse has a heel turn, so if you need to go over some tips on how to do a heel turn, we actually do go into details about that double reverse in our heel turn tutorial, which you can get to right here. All right, so let's go over your part. So we're starting off with our heel turn and our double reverse, so I'll pick up my pants a little bit so you can see. So I'm gonna go back on my right foot, dance my heel turn. I'm gonna go kind of, I always say that it's a forward step. I know that in the technique book it says a side step. Technically, what I like to call the step is a forward to end side. So what I mean by that is that my entire right side swings forward, but I'm rotating at the same time. So the direction of my swing is forward, but I am rotating, so then I'm gonna end side, yeah? So yes, if someone describes it as a sideways step, they're correct. I describe it as a forward to end side. So you swing forward, but because you're turning, you end side. So that's the side step. Now from this position here, you're gonna continue to rotate your right foot as you cross the left foot in front. Now I think Simeon mentioned when he was going over the guy's part that normally he's lowering, but in this case, when he stays up, that tells us that we're going to do the overspin. So now we're gonna take our right foot kind of back and diagonal to the right and down to a reverse pivot at the end of that measure. The timing of this is really important. It's gonna be quite quick because the guy wants to do his reverse pivot on the three count, which means that we need to fit in all four steps of our double reverse in the first two counts. So we dance our double reverse with a timing of one, two, and a three. Okay, so two and a three. So we have three steps in one beat, okay? So if I do that timing again, I'm going to go one, two, and a three. So I've ended now down into my right leg, yeah, lowered into my right leg and ready to go into my hover corte. Our part is really difficult in this step. Guys' part's pretty easy, yeah. Girls' part, very hard, okay? So what we have to make sure that we're doing is from this position here. Normally, I would keep my foot on the ground and just drag it in as I'm rising to my toe. But with the develope, I'm going to pick up my foot early on. So I want to make sure that I'm actually balanced on my right foot, because the develope, obviously, I have to be only on one foot. So I want to make sure that I pick up my left foot early on so that I can spend the entire time that we're rising to kind of monitor where my balance is. Yeah, that's how I make a good-looking develope. So I've arrived in promenade. Now I'm going to pick up my foot, okay? Now from here, as we start to rise and rotate to close, I keep my foot underneath me, yeah? So what I'm gonna do is from my foot back, I'm now gonna lift up my knee. In fact, I'm almost making like a number four with my legs. So I'm going from here where my knees are together. Now I'm gonna lift up my foot, so I'm making a number four, but I wait for Simeon to lower. It's when he lowers that I actually extend my leg in the developé, and then place it softly on the ground. Now we do our outside change to promenade, so I'm gonna step forward with my right foot, outside partner. One, forward in between his feet on two, turn my shoulders as he moves across me into promenade position for three, and then our passing natural, one, two, three. Now we're gonna go over some more details together.
So when I do my hover, yeah, I keep my hips generally vertical, yeah? So when I finish my double reverse spin, I'm down low, but hips are vertical. I go back on my right foot. My hips are still hanging underneath me. They're not forward or back. When I step to the side, they're underneath me. Again, they're not back or forward. The back one is very common because people try to kind of scoop forward into the hover, and then as a result, the leg starts to fall back.
But nevertheless, they're underneath me. I go up, they're still vertical underneath me. They might be a little bit more forward, but not much. And then when I lower, again, on the outside change, on the first step of the outside change, my hip is underneath me. I don't let it stick out. It's nicely underneath me. I don't really think much forward or backward. I just want it to be flexible at all times.
All right, ladies, so a couple things for you about the develop base specifically. So develop base is actually quite difficult for the ladies. So I want to give you guys a few tips for how to develop that develope and to practice it to make it better. The first thing is practice it by yourself. You can use a wall to help with balance. I'm going to use Simeon. It doesn't take a, you shouldn't be using the wall too much, yeah? Just a little bit, okay? So we did this a few times just holding the hand like this to actually practice, so I didn't have to go walking for a wall every time I wanted to practice my developé. The first thing is, let's go through a few pitfalls first and then how to fix them. Number one is, ladies, try to kick from here, okay? This is gonna be really difficult to get your leg up high, all right? So don't extend the leg too soon. Okay, you want to actually pick your knee up as much as you can and then extend the leg. Yeah, so the leg goes up, extend, lower. And that idea of picking up the knee and extending it, that is what makes it a developé by definition. Okay? Second pitfall is when you extend the leg, because it's difficult and maybe you don't have enough strength, you bring your body towards your leg. So we go up and then you go in with the body. This is so common for ladies when they first start doing this movement. It's difficult, but as you extend the leg, you have to create an arc with the upper back. So you're gonna bring the leg up as high as you can. The higher the leg goes, the more you pull in your belly button. And now as you release the leg, you're going to arc the upper back so that it stays, basically you want your body to make a V. Yeah? So your body arcs like this, the leg develops like this. So we don't go, yeah? That's the common one, okay? The next pitfall that we need to watch out for is, once we start to develop the leg, no flicking, okay? So we see da-da, yeah? It's not waltzy, it's not foxtrotty. The only time it's ever appropriate is in tango. So don't do it for waltz or foxtrot. Most times ladies flick the leg because they're not strong enough to keep the leg up there. So they're going da 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 and they're like, oh God, I can't make it anymore. Kick the leg, okay? You have to make sure that you develop the strength to be able to release it softly. So we go, lift the knee as high as you can, pull in the belly button, arc the upper back, and softly extend the leg. Now the last pitfall is dropping the foot down on the ground with no control. So it goes up, softly extend, okay? Seen it many times, yeah? So ladies, again, that usually comes because of lack of strength, yeah? So you have to make sure, even if you just develop it this much, but you place it softly on the ground, that's gonna look better than going, okay? So we go lift from the knee, arc the upper back, soft, soft, okay? Now, I'm going to show it to you with partner and give you one more tip, and that's for how we get into that developé. So, as we're coming through for the developé action, remember I said that in the hover, my hip goes as he starts to rise. Now, because my hip goes, my foot moves underneath me, so I'm going to get to this position here with my back foot. Then, as he continues to rise, that's when I bring my knee up. When he lowers, I do my extension, and then as he rises, I push to softly place it on the ground. Definitely not easy to do, but it takes a lot of practice and a lot of development of that action in and of itself. So ladies, if you want to be able to get your foot up there, you have to practice it by yourself. No guys there. Don't rely on the guy to hold you up, and he's certainly not going to pick your foot up for you. Okay? So, it's all up to you and how much strength you can build. It takes a lot of strength in the center, in this part of the leg, and actually in this part of the leg to stabilize while you're doing that developé. So, it's all up to you.
Thank you for joining us today. Hopefully you learned a lot, get some great practice in, have fun with it. And if you want to see notifications for our newest videos, hit the bell button.
and make sure you subscribe. We love having our family of subscribers grow and grow. It's great. We love getting the questions from you guys. So if you have any questions, let us know down below. We will do our best to answer those in the comments section. Let us know if there's anything that you would like us specifically to cover, because we are back in action.